mapping function can be used once the instrument is set up and still not reading correct, or you would like to ignore any false echoes or objects that may cause issues in the future. When adding a map to the instrument, you are creating a threshold that will tell the unit to ignore all false signals that fall below the threshold. Adding a map will not cause your device to read incorrectly unless the product has been mapped out. To begin, we will enter into the menu, enter level, level 1, and basic setup. Continue through the menu until you find level 1 check value. This is the menu where you will make your selection on how the mapping should be done. The first parameter will display the actual distance that the sensor sees. The second parameter is check distance. Highlight check distance and hit enter. The most common problem is that the level reading is high. If that is the case, you will need to select distance too small. Let's say, for example, that you know you have 50% product in your tank, but the instrument is reading 75%. The distance that the signal is traveling is going to be less than it should be if the instrument was reading 50%. Remember, as the distance increases, the level decreases, and vice versa. To correct this issue, we can select the option distance too small. Once the parameter has been selected, it will show the actual distance, range of mapping, start mapping, and status. Select start mapping and change this to yes. You will see it say recording map. Once completed, verify the new level reading and distance are correct and the status says enable map. If this is correct, advance to the next screen. If everything is reading correctly, you will hold the two arrow keys together to go back to the main measured value. If the value is still reading incorrect, you may need to repeat the mapping function or check your basic setup for accuracy. You have now completed mapping.